Now you have seen the conservation of the angular momentum and the rotational kinetic energy. Now we will see that what will be the energy of a body which is rolling on the surface, just like the rolling wheel, rolling ball, rolling cylinder. Then what must be their kinetic energy?
Energy of a rolling body . Let's suppose here we are having a body. This is no surface. This is no a body, and this moves with the velocity v, and also it rotates with the angular velocity. So the rolling velocity, this rolling body have two motions: the linear motion and the rotational motion. The rolling body have linear and rotational motion, because they move in this direction, also rotate about their own axis, so they are having this rotational motion. So now we can have the energy of this one. Energy equal to, this is not rotational kinetic energy, linear kinetic energy plus rotational kinetic energy. Then linear kinetic energy, as we know, this is now your half m v square, and rotational kinetic, this is now your half I omega square. This we know. And we can make the change mv square plus half I equal to mk square. Omega equal to v upon r whole square. So this is, now you can take the half mv square common from all these. So we can have a factor half mv square into 1 plus k square upon r square. This is our total energy, E, where k equal to radius of gyration and r the radius of body. So now this half mv square is the linear kinetic energy. Linear kinetic energy. So if we want to find out the ratio with this the ratio of this E with this linear kinetic energy and rotational kinetic energy, then we can have the formula like this one. The linear kinetic energy this is denoted by ke. This is equal to now half mv square, and the rotational kinetic energy this is denoted by the term er, as I have told you earlier. This
This is denoted by the term ET. ET equal to half m b square. ET, T means translational. This is not translational. Linear is also called the translational. Translational. Energy. And now rotation. Kinetic energy. This is denoted by the term ER. This is now your half I omega square. And this is now your half m, this is now your k square, this is now your v upon r, whole square. So this is 1 by 2 m v square into k square upon r square. So now you can take the ratio of this, that you can find that how much percentage of this ER is of the total energy and so on. So this ET upon E, this is now equal to half m v square into half m v square into 1 plus k square upon r square. So this term will cancel. So we will have this ET equal to E upon 1 plus k square upon r square. This is now your expression. And this ER upon E, this we can have half m v square k square upon r square upon half m v square into 1 plus k square upon r square. So this half m v square we can say. So this ER is equal to E into, this is now your k square upon r square divided by 1 plus k square upon r square. This is our relation. The value of k square upon r square is different for the different bodies. The value of k square upon r square is different for different bodies. Different bodies. Now I am taking some example. For ring, k square upon r square is equal to addition of 1, and for disk, k square upon r square equal to 1 by 2, and third, for cylinder, this k square upon r square is equal to 1 by 2. And for thin rod T square upon R square equal to 1 by 12. And now for the sphere, T square upon R square equal to 2 by 5. Like this. So you can also calculate that what will be the value of this E to the total energy of this E. So I take this example, suppose. Ratio of linear kinetic energy to total energy. This is now your ET. As I have told you, ET upon E, this is equal to 1 upon 1 plus K square upon R square. So now suppose you take this for ring. This is 1 upon this is 1 plus 1. So this gives you that this ET equal to E by 2. So this is now 50% of the total energy, or ET equal to 50% of E. So 50% here, that will be 50%, that will be the rotational kinetic energy, clearly. This ER, this is also equal to 50% of E. Both energies are equal in case of ring. For ring, T square upon R square equal to 1. So in case of ring, the ring has 50% of total energy of this the kinetic energy, and 50% of total energy, that is the rotational kinetic energy. And now if I take the example of this, then you can have this formula. Now for this K square upon R square equal to 1 by 2, then this ET upon E, this is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 1 by 2. So this is now 3 by 2. What we are getting? ET equal to 2 by 3 E. So this is now approximate to be 66.6% of E. This is not ET. And the remaining will be ER. ER, this is equal to now your approximately 1/3, so 33. Of E, this is not so much. So with the help of the formula, we can find the that how much will be the rotational energy and the linear kinetic energy of the total energy of the body when this is rolling on the surface. So this is about the rotational, this is about the energy of the body rolling on the surface. So thank you very much.